We're going to go fishing today on the Kamishak River. We're going to be fishing with Guy Jimmy, who's Christopher and I's favorite guide. We fish with him a variety of years. Kamishak's got a lot of big dollies, a lot of dog salmon, chum, whatever you want to call them. Really good on a fly rod. We'll use 8 weights today. We'll be landing a bunch. I imagine we'll see a lot of bears, don't you think, Christopher?
Yeah, I think so.
So we're looking for a great adventure, and we think you'll enjoy it. So sit back and enjoy some great fly fishing. This morning we're here on the Kamishak River. We just came up on a nice float plane ride. How far up the river are we, Jimmy?
We drove about 35 minutes, so about 8 miles or so.
Let me introduce Jimmy. Jimmy is our favorite guide, and we fish with each year and understands all these rivers in this basin and in the watershed area. So what fish are we going to catch first?
Well, we're going to target Dolly Varden right now. We've got some chums and pinks up here, and they might be on the spawn right now, but the dolly should be right in behind them. So we're going to throw some egg patterns, indicator, standard, and infrarig for Dolly Varden.
All right. They're not very deep. It's only about 6 inches deep right there.
Yeah, he's a little bit thicker. Yeah, he's still fresh in from the ocean.
Yeah, they're fall spawners, so they start to change color when.
Well, that's a little bit better.
Yeah, that's a nice. That's a nicer fish. Oh yeah, what do you say, 21?
I don't know if he's that big.
Alaska Sportsman's Lodge was built in 1997. We use float-equipped aircraft to take us from our home river here to various streams throughout Katmai National Park and Preserve, and also over on the Nooshagak drainage. A lot of these flights are only 10, 15, 20-minute flights away, and it gives us a lot of access. And the key to the reason why this lodge was built here is because we have great fishing right out the front door. The lodge consists of a main lodge building, complete with a dining area, a very nice great room with views of the river. Our flyout program consists of two de Havilland Beavers, a Cessna 206 and a Cessna 180, all on floats. Here at Alaska Sportsman's Lodge, we have a complete staff that consists of guides, pilots, maintenance people, two full-time chefs. The chefs have the schedule, and they make sure that there's plenty of food and that it's of high quality.
He's fighting it. Yeah, it is. This one might take a little bit. This one's a little bit stronger. I don't know, it's a little bit stronger of a fish. Yeah, that's a nice one. You want to tend to him, or you want me to take care of it, Jimmy?
Daddy.
Yeah.
Nice.
pretty fish. Take a look at this one, G-Man.
Is he a nice one?
Oh, yeah.
They don't like to be held.
Sure. Been in the river for a little bit, not quite as silvery. It's interesting compared to yesterday. We're closer to the coast, and the spots on them are not quite as bright orange as the ones. Did you notice that? Is that just
yesterday?
Yeah, they were the spots on the ones yesterday, and the little coo were more orange, brighter orange. Is that just because of the proximity to the ocean?
Yeah, you know, they're fall spawners, and those fish have come all the way up the Alagnac as well, you know, into that river you were fishing yesterday. These came right up from Kamishak Bay here. So once you get in towards the fall, late August into September, they start getting a lot more color, more vibrant spots there. Dark, dark green back, orange belly, orange lips. You can kind of see a little bit of orange there starting to show on the lips.
Yeah. Yep, I think you're right. Nice fish. Good fighters too.